Hello and welcome everyone, this is Frogger here from Achievement Hunter, here to continue my guide in the cheeriest, most pleasant game ever, Splatterhouse. Now, we are going to be continuing with our collectibles guide. We actually have some gramophones, so we're actually going towards audiophile for once. Thumbs up.
Phase 6, Beast with a Human Heart.
Ah, Phase 6. And speaking of heart, actually I love that line by The Mask. You will get to this part after a fairly lengthy side scroll, so about maybe 10-20 minutes into this level. You're going to bump into this one, but you may not, because you may not strike those boxes on the left-hand side, and if you don't, holy crap, no more gen picture for you. Now, moving forward a little bit later on in the level, you're going to get to this room where you kind of have to pull some levers, activate a door and some crap, you know, normal stuff. There's three collectibles in this area, so from that star, as I showed you, go to the right, bam, gramophone. Now, back from where we were before, it's in the back right-hand corner. This is the one that you don't have to go to progress in the level, but if you don't, you're kind of dumb. I'm just saying that right now, deal with it. just progress a little bit. Oh, God, this guy! And, you know, he just... After I collected that picture, he just randomly, spontaneously combusted. You can see there on the ground, there's just blood everywhere. I have no idea how it happened. I just kind of looked at him. He said, "Oh my God, it's you," and just exploded and died. I guess Rick is just that fucking awesome. Now, on the left side of where we just were, another door to rip open with our mighty awesomeness, you're going to see a little bit of a path here you have to follow with some stuff. Because I was kind of like taken aback, like, "Oh my God, they're making me do something?" And just kind of bowled through there and found an extra gramophone. So we're like, oh yeah, gramophone, yay. This is another one under the file underneath. If you don't see this one, you're kind of blind. Literally, you have to be, you're going to be in this elevator for a good 10 minutes. Kind of hard to miss it. Now, as you fight through like a giant dome area filled with enemies, you're going to get to this part here, and there's dudes on the right. And just... Over here, almost done with the boar worm, so I'm like, gotta get all the boar worms, because I'm at like 950 something here, so I'm very close to the 1,000. And then if I can get, you know, behind the door, hey now, it looks like Jen forgot some clothes for once in this video. God, Jen, I'm trying to get viewers here. I mean, trying to show pictures here. Yeah.
Phase 7, Scream Park.
Yeah. So at the very beginning of the next level, this is literally the beginning. I'm like, how do I get through this door? Oh, I hit it. And you want to go to the left-hand side behind the really kind of creepy dog. And there's a shack, and you do whatever you do to shack, and you just beat the crap out of it. And I probably could have phrased that better, but I don't care. And you can see here, where's the picture? I kind of was like, okay, what the hell just happened? So I, you know, paused the game, but nope, I had to hit the back button, so I did. And there's the picture. Apparently I collected it. Kill him, Ricky boy. Now in the skee ball area, where you have to literally play skee ball with bodies, just grab one very easily like I do here, there's a lot of them, and hit Y, toss them, and then it opens the door there. It has to be the one on the left, and it opens that door there. So there you go. So we're going to go over there and grab it, and go nom. And it looks like Jen decided to get clothed again. Okay. Now in the Tunnel of Love, as you can plainly see, you'll see what looks to be Jen about now. Oh, wait, no. Now!
Oh, there God. It is.
Hi, Jen-ish thing. And where she was standing is the next picture. Now, towards the end of what's pretty much like a Cave of Horrors, you go to the left, it ends the level, but if you go right, there's a picture. Now, I recommend going right. There's a lot more enemies you can kill, and a katana. So you actually get a decent weapon, too, so keep that in mind.
Phase 8, Reflections in Blood.
That just sounds like a metal song. Reflections in Blood. Now, as you can see, the beginning cutscene, second hot dog stand, punch it open like you mean business, and then you get a picture. Now, right when you're about to enter the Hall of Mirrors, there's going to be this picture here. Now, this Hall of Mirrors is kind of confusing, so I kind of kept some of it in, so I hope you understand what I'm doing here. So you can see here, I'm about to end the side-scrolling section. It's going to lock me in. Now, what I would recommend doing first every time is Make sure that you break open the window that you need to move on, as opposed to just breaking all the mirrors, because you have to defeat everything in that a lot of time. So, as I saw what I did, I took a left, then I went straight, then I double backed and hit the right one so I can get the picture, which I'm getting now. I mean, seriously, it's in a hall of mirrors. It's confusing. So, after you collect this gen picture, there's going to be two more of these rooms. I cut one out, but it's pretty much you take a right. You see here, I take the next right, and it's going to kind of throw you into a side-scrolling section right... Well, come on, now. And this one is very hard to miss, because since you're on a two-dimensional plane, you're gonna walk into it, unless you just happen to jump over it. But, you know, whatever. And hey, we got Creepy Show, which we have 8 of the gen's pictures. We are getting there. But that is it for now. This is Fragger signing off. Make sure to check Achievementer.com for more videos and shenanigans.